there. Good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London. We are in the psychedelics space this afternoon with Clara Burtenshaw here from Kuma Ventures. A very good day to you, Clara. How are you?
Very well, thanks, Katie. Lovely to meet you. Thank you for having us today.
Absolute pleasure. So we're going to learn more about what you do. So maybe just introduce your company to us, first of all.
Sure. Kuma Ventures is a psychedelics fund based in London. We're a £20 million fund, and we were the first solely focused psychedelics fund here, really focusing on market disruptors and category leaders at the forefront of psychedelic healthcare and digital therapeutics in the mental health space. It's led by me and my partner, Sean McClintock, and strategic and scientific advisors who hold a number of industry and board positions. And we're on a mission to build world-class companies that are going to transform the healthcare sector and improve standards of patient care. We don't invest in the recreational side of psychedelics or microdosing. We're really focused on the clinical research aspect and investing in companies that are going to produce the blockbuster drugs of tomorrow and leading digital therapeutics for patient care.
You said world-class and blockbuster drugs. What are you actually looking for in a company for you to take interest on, for you to want to invest in it?
So we invest across three different pillars. Mm-hmm. We invest across drug discovery and drug development, also clinics and delivery services, and then also a host of complementary digital therapeutics and interventions, and also platforms, data aggregators, and all of the picks and tools that will be required to create this industry of patient care around psychedelic healthcare in the future. If we're looking at the drug discovery, drug development side of the industry, we like to take more of a biotech and VC approach to this. So what we're looking for in drug development are three things. The first is a team, an excellent team who has got a background in bringing drugs through clinical trial and either sales to big pharma or distribution themselves. Also, we are looking for leading intellectual property. So for us, that means drugs that are being built up with the correct patents in place. So if there's not something that has a novel composition of matter or a new chemical entity attached to it, we tend not to invest, because we're coming at this from the perspective of wanting to invest in companies that have got the intellectual property to be able to commercialize this product for a 20-year period. Mm-hmm. And we have to be really excited about the product ourselves to invest. And so for us, what that means is looking for companies that are trying to target indications and illnesses that are currently not very well served by the pharmaceutical toolkit. And so if we're looking at psychedelics, they lend themselves very well to the treatment of anything involving the brain or the central nervous system. So major depressive disorders, PTSD, addictions, various types of eating disorders or obsessive compulsive disorder, and pain management. And if you look at the current host of drugs that are available to treat those illnesses, they do very well, but a lot of them carry with them some negative side effects, and they're perhaps not the best type of treatment for a particular patient. And what we've seen with psychedelics is the ability to really get to the root cause of the problem through the way the psychedelics work. And that means developing drugs that could potentially really address the root cause of the problem, as opposed to acting like a patch on an existing problem, which is how a lot of the current drugs operate if they're targeting biochemical imbalances in the brain.
Yeah.
And what's really exciting is we've got this opportunity now to pick out illnesses that do not have adequate drugs at the moment and develop the leading drugs of the future. And we've seen this supported by the FDA and the EMA and regulators who are now recognising the potential for these to become new treatment paradigms.
Yeah, as you mentioned there, maybe let's talk about that, because psychedelics, they are becoming more well known, our knowledge is improving on them. And of course, as well as you mentioned, regulators, they're steadily increasing their sort of enthusiasm for them. In regards to the market and how you think we could maybe have a boom on our hands here?
I think, like all nascent spaces, there are a lot of early movers who do very well. And then you get sort of other players coming along later who perhaps learn from their mistakes or innovating upon their product. And so whilst we've seen a huge amount of excitement and, you know, three companies becoming billion-dollar companies on the NASDAQ, we really see this as a long-term opportunity where these drugs that are going through clinical trial will take several years to receive approval, and some may not receive approval, may not get through the trial. And what we're seeing now is a very high caliber of seasoned scientists and biotech really looking at the sector now as a promising opportunity for growth. And so I think we have to take quite a cautious approach as investors. It's very easy to get really excited about a particular company, especially when there's a lot of hype about it. But for us, we're looking at this from the perspective of, if you took the word psychedelic out of the company, would you still be excited about the product they're developing? Have they got the fundamentals in place that make this a very good investment in the short and sort of medium and long term? Because the danger, I think, with exciting markets is that often the retail investor can be left with stocks that perhaps were at inflated values and become worthless over time. So by investing the best science, the best scientists, teams and IP, we hope to be able to ride that wave long term, yeah, and back the horses that will win at the end. And I think there are lots of companies looking at some of the same indications. Some have stronger teams and science than others. And what we're trying to do by building up the correct scientific team around us is really diligence these companies, de-risk it as much as possible, and back the horses that will win the race. And we're really excited about the science and the scientists that are looking at this field, the research that's coming through. And so we see this really as the beginning of a new type of treatment that will take years to fully explore, and backing the early companies that will hopefully do best out of it.
Clara Burtenshaw, thank you so much indeed talking to us today from Neo Kuma Ventures here on Proactive London about your investment thesis there.